After that breaking news, Vanessa De La Vigna now live in Duncan at the scene where a school bus caught on fire. Vanessa.
Yeah, Fred, you know, some terrifying visuals out here. You can see that school bus right behind me here, just completely charred after this fire. I'm here with the superintendent, Scott Turner, who you got the call around 7 this morning. Tell me, what was your reaction to hearing what was going on?
I got the call that the bus was on fire, but I could see the smoke as I came up 290 toward the bus, and I asked the person who called me, "Is that the smoke that I'm seeing?" And he said, "Yes." All the streets were blocked off. I got through. When I saw this bus, my heart dropped. I mean, it was terrifying to see that, but I'd already been told that all the students had been evacuated. They were all safe. We were transporting them to school, making sure we could contact their parents to let them know they were safe. I went and consoled the driver because she did a wonderful job of evacuating 56 students in less than a minute. I can't praise her enough for the work that she did.
Absolutely. Just some quick thinking on her part. You said some students noticed the smoke. That's how it started.
Yes, she was notified by some students who were on the back of the bus.
Wow. And so luckily, like we said, able to get everybody off the bus. All those students are safe. They're now at school, and
yes,
we're just left behind with this here.
Yes, and they'll do an investigation. The fire departments, the State Department of Education is on scene with their transportation department to figure out exactly what caused the fire.
Great. Thank you so much, Scott. Like we said, we're still trying to figure out what exactly started this fire here, but like he said, some terrifying visuals. All of the students were evacuated safely thanks to the quick actions of that bus driver. Live in Duncan, Vanessa De La Vigna, 7 News.
Thank you, Vanessa. 80